Hi, welcome back to the channel. I'm so glad that you are here. Thank you. Today I'm going to share with you 6 tips to enjoy flying with your infant, your baby, on the planes. Since summer is here and a lot of family going away for holiday, this is gonna be great one for you to enjoy your time with your child on the plane, so there no screaming, no shouting, no disturbing other people around you, because obviously they have the right to enjoy their peaceful and calm flight as much as you, the parents. And this is no involving with laptop, iPad, phone, or movie. Here we go. Are you taking your child on an airplane soon? It is a situation that strikes fear into the heart of most parents, because obviously you are trapped in a closed space for a long period of time and you can't leave it. And the kids are known for having a hard time giving parents a hard time, because they are stuck in one place and they are having a hard time themselves as well. But there are things you can do to make an airplane trip actually pretty painless, easy, calm, peaceful, joyful as much as possible. So let's talk about what they are first and when to get to the airport. So tip number one is get to the airport early. Certainly, when you leave the house, getting the car is normally take an hour or two for you to get to the airport. So by the time the kid gets out of the car, they already ready to move around, ready to stretch themselves and start acting as much as they can, explore as much as they can. So you want to get to the airport early so the child have time to explore and release those tensions on the car that they've been holding, and then they start moving, ready to move around. So aim to get there as early as possible you can, so the child have time to explore in the airport and walk around and look at everything in the airport. And you will find that by the time you get on the plane, they will be ready for a nap. Tip number two is following tip number one: get the child active and moving. Because before they get on the plane, if you get them moving a lot, they will be ready to take a nap. And it's a very least they sort of getting about when it's a little bit more, when they sit in one place. So before they go and sit in one place that they have to stuck there all the time, they have time to explore. Let them explore around, running around. Most of the airport nowadays, they have a section for children to play. Some of them actually have a dedicated playground for children's penthouse or an activity area for children and run around. You don't have to get on the plane. You might be the first person get on the plane. Let your kids spend more time running around the airport, making friends, connect with other people, looking around and familiar themselves. Then by the time they go on the plane, they will ready for a nap. Okay, and I normally be the last person to get on the plane, because I know for sure by the time I sit down, I'm stuck to that one spot. And my baby, because I've been traveling with my infant many times, over from the UK to the US, I'm here to Cyprus, to so many Europe countries. I know that by the time we're stuck in that seat, the baby got to be on my lap all the way from where we start until we landed. If you have another child, they will be stuck in their seat just like you. And we all know children are not very good with sitting at one spot all the time. So be the last person to get on that seat. That leads me to tip number three, which is prepare your child before to get on the plane. So if your child knows that they will have certain hour that they need to be in one spot, and they know that the first moment when they get on the plane, they need to behave. I wouldn't say behave. They need to be calm and stay still and sit still. Then they are aware of what's coming. So basically, you just got to talk to your child and communicate with your child and telling them, right now, darling, we are about to get on the plane to go to the other side, enjoy our holiday, see grandma, grandpa, or, you know, while we're going home. So when you get on the plane, do you know what we need to do? We got to sit still, we got to be nice, we got to be calm. And if you need anything, let mama and papa know. If they know how to talk. If they're not able to communicate yet, do let them know. So, because baby, they can understand what you're saying. And if you saying that one, try and three times, they will get into the mindset, the position to prepare it. You might think that an infant won't know about it, but try it and you will see what a miracle it will be. Tell your baby, when we get on the plane, you got to fall asleep, all right? And you will see that your baby will falling asleep. That's how my trick. That's what I did. And obviously, they're not gonna sleep throughout 9 hours when we fly to Florida. She didn't fly through nine hours. Just sleep. But obviously, prepare for the child. Communicate with the child before you get on the plane. It's a great idea. Tip number 4. Bring in a surprise toy bag. Yes. That a lot of time, the first time ever, I forgot to do this. And then after that, my mom remind me. And that is a great, great thing ever you have. Because my baby was just an infant, and only have a box. Because she loved to open box and get everything inside the box and throw them around. So I've got a carton box. And then I fill it up with the little toy. Either a small shaker, a mint box that she can make noise with, something that she can chew on, any little stuff, just 4 or 5 items, small items that fit in a small box that will entertain the baby, the infant, greatly. If you have a bigger children, you can brought with you different toys, a bigger toys. You can put them in a lightweight backpack bag, and then you give them when you get on the plane, you give them that, and it will be a surprise that they can play for a while. So you can get settled down, and maybe you don't give them all the time all at once, give them one every time, because it takes time for children to explore as one particular child toy. And then when they're fed up, you get the second one out and the third one out. So brought 4 or 5 toys with you, that will help you greatly. Tip number 5 is bring snacks. That is a lifesaver for me, because obviously my baby love eating. I love eating myself, so snacking is a great thing. Bring healthy stuff is good. If you can't, unhealthy is okay. But don't bring a lot of fries and chips and things like that. Do your best to bring fruit, juice. Fruit, if you can chop up the fruit beforehand at home. Frozen yogurt. Yes, she loves frozen yogurt. Or dry fruit. And dry, for example, dry apple. She loves that so much. Baby loves that, they like munching on it. Tip number 6. This is more for the parents, but it's really, really help your kid. Is stay calm and relax. If you are in a panicking, you in a rush, you know what is gonna reflect on your child, and your child, they unable to regulate their emotion because they are still growing, still learning. You should be able to regulate your emotion. If you are calm, if you relax, so if the child throw a tantrum, scream, or do anything that you think is not appropriate in public, then stop, breathe in, breathe out, and then be calm and deal with that moment. There are no reason to be panicking, to be shouting, to be overly react to certain things that the child doing, because that won't, will not help you or the child either. You stay calm, the whole journey gonna be nice, and the whole, and your child is gonna see that reflection on you, so they will also stay calm throughout the journey as well. Obviously, a lot of parents nowadays, when they got on the plane, turned the screen on, give the children the laptop, the iPad, but remember, those affect your child's mind greatly. Instead of doing that, I would highly recommend to bring small book, a rhythm book, a drum book, a verse book, anything that you can spend time with your child. So instead of they on a they on an iPad, you on a phone, how about brought a small book with you and reading with your child, or reading to your child? My baby, her most favorite book is There's a Rocket in My Pocket, and she love it, love it every single time that I read to her. There's something with rhythm and verse that just attract the child so much. So there you go, that's my 6 tips to you. And if you, anyone on the plane complain about your child, then just smile and telling them that we have a many better day than this, and they will immediately understand and be sympathy with you. So don't worry if your child bothered other people. They probably have children, they understand, and if they don't, they don't. You can't really do anything. So if you like this 6 tip, give me a thumb up and leave in the comment below, what do you do with your child to have a calm, peaceful and happy flight with your child. So hopefully I can add that to my list to do with my child on the plane. She grow up now, so I got to find different things as well to entertain her, for her to entertain herself. Thank you ever so much for watching. And again, subscribe to the channel, click on the bell so you'll be notified every time I have a new video. And I see you next time. Bye bye.